What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English vid. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 10 advanced adjectives that will come in handy when taking your CAE and CPE exams. Are you ready? So take a notebook and let's kick off. First, we're going to learn two C1 adjectives and the rest will be C2. So the first adjective is upcoming. Upcoming. It means happening soon. And now let's look at two examples. The first, he's studying hard for his upcoming exam. And the second example about me, I'm excited about my upcoming trips. In 2020, I'm traveling to Dublin and New York. So guys, if you have any recommendations, let me know in the comments below. Let's move on to our second adjective, which is state of the art. It means very modern and using the most recent ideas and methods. It's a synonym of cutting edge, which is also level C1. And now two examples. The first one, the company is investing in state-of-the-art technology. And the second example, I was amazed by the city's state-of-the-art facilities. Now let's start with our C2 adjectives. Number three, crystal clear. Apart from meaning very clean and clear, for example, when you talk about water, it also means very easy to understand. The first example, thanks for your explanation. Now it's crystal clear. And the second example, it's crystal clear that education is the cornerstone of society. Let's continue our adjective number four, lavish. Lavish. It means expensive, impressive, or luxurious. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, she's leading a lavish lifestyle. And the second example, thanks for such a lavish lunch. Number five, the adjective elaborate. Elaborate. It has two meanings. The first one is carefully prepared and organized. For example, it's the most elaborate wedding I've ever been to. It's planned to the smallest detail. And the second meaning of this adjective is complex and very complicated. For example, the document is rather elaborate. I need to read it again. Our adjective number six is frantic. Frantic. It also has two meanings. The first one is worried or anxious. For example, my mom got frantic when she found out that her bag was gone. It actually happened to us once in a restaurant. And another meaning of frantic is done in a hurry and in a disorganized way. For example, the party is tomorrow, so the preparation is being frantic. Let's continue adjective number seven, flawless. Flawless. Pronunciation long O. Flawless. It means perfect and without mistakes. It's an advanced adjective to replace perfect. And now two examples. The first one, your composition is flawless. Kudos. And the second example, Rami Malek won an Oscar for his flawless performance as Freddie Mercury. Let's continue number eight, coherent. Coherent. The pronunciation is a bit tricky, is co, the stress goes on he, coherent, coherent, and the opposite is incoherent, incoherent, and it means clear and easy to understand. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, she gave a coherent explanation for her actions. And the second example, his speech was clear and coherent. Second to last adjective, detrimental. Detrimental. It means harmful and damaging. And it's quite formal. And now two examples. The first one, air pollution has detrimental effects on people's health. And the second example, sunbathing with no sunscreen is detrimental to your skin. And last but not least, the adjective dim. Very short, dim. And it means not having enough light. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, reading in dim light can be harmful to your eyes. And the last example, the streets were quiet and dim. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this English bit and found these 10 adjectives useful. Please make sure you like this lesson, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notifications so that you know whenever there is a new English bit. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!